Hi everybody, this is Jake, your resident content cowboy here. Yeehaw! And we are here with the mobile release of Pokémon Unite. I've had a few people ask me for my settings when I'm playing Pokémon Unite on mobile. I will say, I think I'm a lot better on Switch than I am on mobile. I'm still getting used to this a little bit, but let me show you how I set up my controls for the game. As far as system settings, I believe graphics quality is going to be based on your phone. I have a relatively new phone, and I haven't seen any issues with frame rate dropping, so I keep frame rate high and graphics quality high. Language, keeping it English, because it's the only one I happen to speak. And yeah, all this other stuff, you can do whatever you want with it. Vibrate, display text chat, hide trainer names once met. You know, you can do whatever you like with that. Let's head on over to controls. Here in controls, this is where you're going to be making a few decisions. Also, something I will mention, if you're playing on both your phone and your Switch, get ready, because when you switch back and forth, things will change and it's kind of frustrating. As far as opponent lock-on priority is concerned, you either have lowest remaining HP as a percentage, lowest remaining HP value, or closest. Closest is probably the weakest option here, because if your opponents are playing right, they're putting a defender between you and the people you want to KO faster. I like, personally, lowest remaining HP value. Sometimes someone with a low remaining percent might be a defender that happens to have a low percentage of health, but actually a lot of health and defense otherwise. So I personally like lowest remaining HP value so that I can actually take out who has the least amount of HP, ideally. Your attack controls, I think advanced controls make sense for both the Switch and for the phone. All the difference is, if you just look, there's just a little guy in there. That little guy is a wild Pokemon. You can hit that button and it attacks a wild Pokemon instead of attacking an enemy. Pretty useful when you're fighting in lane. You're going to want to have that on. Automatic basic attacks. Some people have that on, some people have that off. I personally have that off. I don't usually need my character to be doing anything that I'm not telling them to do. You could have it on, so if there's a moment where you're not thinking, it'll start attacking someone around you and can maybe get you some extra KOs or some wild Pokemon. In general, I don't like my game doing anything that I'm not specifically saying for it to do. Lock-on icon. This is interesting. Lock-on icon, both on Switch and on mobile, I don't have on currently. I think it is a more advanced way to play, and I'll show you what it looks like here. You actually have icons around you of enemies that you can hit. And it's a good way to target the weaker people. For instance, if there's a Snorlax around and a Lucario around, I would rather probably hit the Lucario so I could take out the bigger damage dealer of the two. However, I've found, at least on Switch, this has created some weird scenarios where if you're close to hitting the Lucario, but you're not in range yet, and you are in range of the Snorlax and you want to keep doing your basic attacks, if you have that selected on Lucario, you will not be attacking Snorlax. So there are these big moments where you are not attacking anyone. That's personally why I have the lock-on icon off, again, both on mobile and Switch. I want to play around with it some more on mobile so I can say for sure, but right now I have it off because I want all my attacks to be hitting something. Even if it's a defender, that's fine with me. I just don't want to stand there doing nothing, and that's what happens sometimes. Let's see. Move aim settings. You can pull this up here, and this is in conjunction with the lock-on icon, so they don't let me do anything with this because I have that off. In-motion pursuit distance, standard in melee. I just have in-motion pursuit off. Even though in-motion pursuit is off, you still kind of get some in-motion pursuit happening, so you kind of, your Pokemon will try to automatically approach your enemies with some moves anyway. I'm not really sure why. Even if you have it off, they will do it. Scoring controls, without question, do not have hold down button. Have press button. It's just so much easier. If you get attacked during a scoring animation, you have press button on, you can just press the button again. If you have hold down, you're holding it the whole time, then you gotta hold it again. It's just, I can't tell you how many times I've scored because I have press instead of hold. Move canceling controls. This is really personal preference, but I think sliding to the icon, there's just a little red X at the top of your screen. I think just sliding to the icon is easier because it's the same place every single time. I could show you that here in practice mode. Move panel sensitivity. It's just how sensitive it is to move it around. Camera follows moves I have on. I'll show you that as well in practice. It just lets you scout a little bit while you're aiming an ability. Move aim follows movement direction. This one is pretty good. I have it on because if you have this on and you're doing some sort of dash, you'll dash in the direction you're going rather than dashing towards the enemy you're possibly trying to get away from. So that's why I have this on. And then I have move aim snaps to nearby targets off. My thought process here is similar. I might be using one of my moves to get away, and I don't want that targeted at an enemy that I'm possibly running from. Let's see. Camera sensitivity, slide, or movement panel. I haven't messed with this much. I've just had it on slide the whole time, and I have my camera sensitivity usually a little higher than this, actually. It keeps getting lower. When I go back and forth to switch, my camera sensitivity keeps dropping. Battle info. Show trainer name above the HP gauge. This is personal preference, but I don't see why not. Boosted attack gauge. You definitely want to have this on. Absolutely. It lets you know when your next attack is a boosted attack, and that's very important. Show cooldown decimal values. I have it on. It's not a big deal, but it's fun. And highlight outlines for opposing Pokemon on screen edges. Yeah, sure. Why not? It's not a big deal. The rest of it are settings that you don't need to worry too much about. Let's head into the practice area. This top left area, practice, I think it's very, very important. Of course, if you haven't done the tutorial, do the tutorial. You can head into the practice area and play with any Pokemon, whether you have them or not. This is a great way to test people that you haven't tried yet, and it's a great way to get better with some of the Pokemon you like. Let's take a look at Venusaur. Why not? Inside here, you can click this battle prep button. You can set up your battle items, decide what you want to take into the arena. You can change your held items right in here. You can look at all your moves right here. Ooh, which move do I want? You'll be able to pick them in game. You can switch between two move sets, even though it doesn't really matter because you will be choosing them as you go. And then you can start with Venusaur against this computer enemy as a Blissey. So, inside this practice area right here, there are a ton of great things you can do. I'm just going to show you the settings inside here. A few things. First off, up at the top left here, that little wrench up at the top left, it opens this. You can up your level in here. Again, this is just a great place to test your abilities. So you can up your level. You can make yourself invincible if you just want to try moves and not get hurt. You can get rid of move cooldowns so you can spam your abilities over and over again and just get used to how they cast. You can also get wild Pokemon on and off. You can have a substitute doll up with stats. There are a lot of things that you can do inside here. Let's just pick sort of the Solar Beam Venusaur. This is going to help illustrate my point about one of our commands. Obviously, you're moving around over here on the left. Hey! And on the right, you're aiming. So this ability, and here you can mess with your controls. This one right about, come on. Move aim follows movement direction. Camera follows moves. That's the one I'm trying to talk about. Sorry, I'm an idiot. Camera follows moves. So you can see this is our camera right here. I can take two fingers on a phone and move it around. But if I want to be moving my Pokemon and actively looking at my enemies without moving my two fingers, if I want to sort of see what's around me a little bit, if I have a long range move like Solar Beam and I'm aiming it around, you see the camera moves with it. It kind of stretches out to the side there, stretches down here. So you actually get a little more vision. We can see that Lillipup right there. Now, I'll cancel this. You can see our normal vision does not see that Lillipup. Again, because this move has a very long range, it's showing me where it will go, and we get to hit that Pokemon that we might not have known about otherwise. It's a great way to see enemies on the map. Again, practice mode I think is really great. You should definitely spend some time here. Spam your abilities, throw some sludge bombs, use some solar beams. Figure out how things work inside of practice mode. I think these are all the things that you're going to want to know. That's what I'd recommend. Those are my controls. That's what I'm using here on mobile, and I use very similar controls on Switch. Again, if you are playing on Switch And mobile, when you go back and forth, some settings will change. It's kind of frustrating, but just something to notice. Go into your controls, notice what's changed. Usually it's move sensitivity, and sometimes I've had it change some of my choices as to whether my moves follow my aim or not. It's kind of bizarre. I hope this helps. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for listening. I'll see you on the battlefield, where I will be spamming my solar beam. Mwah! Goodbye, everybody. Mwah!